Wow, 2870 students, I would like to just do a brief overview of chapter 1.3. 1.3. 1.3 is going to identify the major levels of organization in organisms, from the simplest to the most complex type of organisms. So when it comes to levels of organization, this is simply levels at which biologists can group things together to describe the basic building blocks of those components. So all living things are made of cells, at least one cell. Even the simplest organisms are made of one cell. And of course, those cells have parts. And so the subcomponents of a cell are made of chemicals. So if you start at the very bottom level of all matter, we're dealing with the atomic level. Atoms are the smallest stable units of matter in general. And atoms join together via chemical bonds to form molecules. Those molecules then can actually interact with other molecules to make macromolecules, which are the building blocks of the parts of a cell. So examples of molecules, obviously water is a great example, but molecules that are very common in living things include things like amino acids. Now, amino acids can join together to make larger molecules, also called macromolecules or biomolecules, because they're so common in living things. Amino acids can join together to form proteins, or at least peptides and polypeptides. Simple sugars can join together to make more complex carbohydrates. So simple sugars are simple carbohydrates, things like glucose and galactose. These can join together to form disaccharides, two sugars joined together, which can join to other sugars and make long chains. In plants, we see things like starch. In animals, we see things like glycogen. We'll talk about glycogen, for example, when we get into a section on muscle and its use there as an energy storage molecule. Other examples of molecules would include things like fatty acids, which can join to other chemicals to make lipids. So we'll talk about phospholipids and triglycerides and steroids and things like that. Those are all under the subcategory of lipids, macromolecules. And of course, we have nucleotides as molecules, which can join together to make nucleic acids, DNA, RNA, these types of macromolecules that are common in living cells. And all of that is discussed in chapter 2 and 3. It's material you should have covered in AP Bio or in Bio 1510 to actually get into this course. So it's kind of assumed you know that. But those are the molecules at the chemical level that make up the parts of a cell. And in cells fall into one of two categories. They're either prokaryotic cells or eukaryotic cells. Of course, we're dealing with human anatomy and physiology, so we're concerned with eukaryotic cells. Organisms that are made of eukaryotic cells include things in the kingdom Protista, the kingdom Fungi, the kingdom Plantae, and the kingdom Animalia. So we are in the kingdom Animalia, or of animals. So our cells are eukaryotic cells. And so at the cellular level, the building blocks of a human are cells. There's about 206 types of cells, and there's four classes or tissue types as far as what cells are made of. So we're going to talk about those very shortly. So at the tissue level, a tissue is just simply cells of a similar type that work together. They physically interact with each other, work together to perform a specific function, and tissues can then join together to make up an organ. So if you take any organ in the body, whether it's a muscle, or you take a structure like the heart, or the stomach, or the brain, it's composed of two or more different tissues working together to perform a specific function. So even if you look at something like, say, your small intestines, if you look at the different layers of it, we find of the all four tissue types that are found in the human body, which include epithelial tissue, nerve tissue, muscle tissue, and connective tissue. So there we have four tissue types, but all organs have are made of two or more different tissue types working together. Of course, organs can function more closely interconnected with other organs to make up a system. So for example, the pharynx or throat and the esophagus and the stomach and the small intestine and the colon and so on can form a system we call the digestive system. And our body is made of about 11 different organ systems, which are the major building blocks of the organism, which would be the organismal level. And that's really the highest level at which we study things in this course. We can go beyond that to population levels and ecosystem levels, but that's not this type of biology course. So we study everything at the organismal level and these subcomponents. What is the human body made of and what do these parts do? These levels are reiterated in this figure. It's very small in the PowerPoint. I just zoom in a little bit. you can see that we start with atoms, the building blocks of molecules, like proteins shown here, actin and troponin and tropomyosin. And these are the building blocks of macromolecules. Other examples of that include things like proteins like myosin here interacting with actin. And these can be parts of the building blocks of a cell, like a muscle cell, skeletal muscle cell, or a cardiac muscle cell in this case, which along with other types of cells, for example, connective tissue, can make up the tissues of the heart. Therefore, we have an organ, which is part of a system, the cardiovascular system, which is one of 11 systems of the human body.